Okay, here's a map view of the area we're going to be looking at today. Off of 93, just south of Wickiup, is milepost 132. At 132 is a road going off into the wilderness area. It twists around and it gets down to 6 Mile Crossing, also known as Burro Creek Crossing. 6 Mile Crossing is what we're going to be looking at today in the video. And if you cross the creek there, the Burro Creek, you eventually get down to the town of Nothing. This crossing was very important during the pioneer days because it was the only accessible way of getting across the Burro Creek. Down here is Burro Creek Campground, which is located at a very deep part of the Burro Creek Gorge, and there's an enormous bridge on 93 that crosses it. Some very rough roads here. This is one of the better positions, but beautiful scenery. Fourteen and a half miles in and 14.5 miles out of pretty bad road. Now here's the kind of end of the road where we're at the crossing itself. Lots of sand, lots of boulders you have to go over. Four-wheel drive is a necessity to get through here. And here's the water. On the other side is the road that will bring you down to the town of Nothing, Arizona. Now, if you can see, the reason you can cross here is if you look in the water, there's a piece of white bedrock that is prominent right at this point, and so it's something you can drive on rather than just say sand and gravel. And but this year, which is 2019, it's currently the month of March, it is very wet, very rainy, and so this creek is about three times the amount of volume going down it as would be in a normal year. It gets to over 105 degrees here in the summer, and this would make a nice refreshing swimming hole to cool off in. Now we're about 100 yards from the water here. We've walked back up the road because I wanted to show you over here. This is the upper campground, and it actually has a lot of advantages to the lower campground. Let's take a look. Here's a view of the lower campground from this plateau, and I'm all alone there. Nobody else anywhere. Yeah, here's the upper campground. It has a series of fire rings and plenty of areas to park and camp. And the big advantage of this, you can look down into the Burro Creek and get a lot of nice views of whitewater. Yeah, here in the upper campground, right at the end, we're at the end of it here. And there is a road going off further down, but it's awfully rocky. Four-wheel drive, highly recommended on this one. Well, we're at the bottom of that road, the steep road, and it flattens out a little bit here, and it probably enough for you to get your SUV down here and maybe pitch a tent. An RV wouldn't be recommended. However, you get great views of the creek up here. We get a little white water going on down there. And we can take a closer look at that. Here's a small side canyon that feeds into the Burro Creek. A little bit of mud in the bottom. We've had some rain over the past few days. And this, of course, feeds down into the whitewater area of the Burro Creek. Nice white water here, going back downstream through a lot of twists and turns, eventually leading into the Colorado River. I wish I had a kayak right now. It would be great to just start floating away. Sea creature here. Looks like it dried out in the sun though. I don't think my dog likes shellfish.